folks, Will from MinIO here with a how-to. Today we're going to be uploading objects to MinIO with .NET, and we're going to be using .NET 6, and we're going to be uploading to our play.min.io sandbox online, and we're going to be running all of this out of Visual Studio 2022. A couple of things I'm going to mention here. Uploading objects with .NET is going to use the same method, the PutObject method, regardless of whether you're uploading a file or a stream. And so I'm going to show both of those here in this next example. And additionally, I'm actually going to show you how to do a stat object. And once we get into the code, you'll see exactly why. Let's take a look at that code. So what I've got going here is the same sort of basic setup where I've got a main method that does a few things for me. It connects to play.min.io. It actually sets up this bucket for me, so I'm not worried about setting up the bucket. But in this case, I'm setting up the bucket with versioning enabled so that you can see some of the versioning stuff that goes on. And last but not least, it's going to handle all of the exception handling right there in the main method, so I'm not cluttering up the code that I'm looking at here with some exception handling. Now, of course, in your own code, you're probably going to want to do the exception handling right where you want to have it. But for now, we're just going to let it all be handled in the main method. So let's go ahead and focus on uploading an object to MinIO. So I have two examples that I'm going to run here. The first is a file example, and I'm uploading to my .NET demo bucket, and I'm going to call the object image.png. The file I'm going to upload is from my local file system. It's just a file called img.png. It's an image file. And so I'm going to set the content type to be image png, as you can see here. When I run the PutObjectAsync, it expects me to hand it a PutObjectArgs. And so that's what I'm going to do. I'm handing it this PutObjectArgs that I'm creating, and I give it the bucket name and the object name. That's going to be common to both our examples. And then I'm going to give it the file name, since I'm going to be uploading a file, and then I'm going to give it this content type just so that I have some extra detail there. Once I've done that, the next thing I need to do is I need to do a stat object. And that stat object itself also takes an args object in order to run. And so I'm going to give it the same bucket name and object name that I used before, just so I can get some information about what I actually uploaded. So you'll notice the PutObjectAsync doesn't actually have a return on it. It just gives you back a task because it's awaitable. And so what I need to do to confirm that it worked is I need to do this stat object. Now the stat object args, very easy to do. I just give it the bucket name, the object name. And then what I get back from that stat object is an object stat object, which has some values in it, like the object name. It's got an e tag, a version ID, content type, and I'm also giving it the size. I'm going to output all of those things. There are some other fields. Those are the important ones for this demo. I'm going to do the same thing again, but with a stream. Now I'm going to use the same file. I'm just going to read it in as a stream instead of uploading it as a file. Now, what are the differences? Well, the main difference is that now instead of with file name, I have to do with stream data. And I also need to give it an object size. So if you do a stream data, you have to hand it an object size. And I'll talk about how to get around that in just one second if you don't know the actual length of your stream. But then again, I'm using the same method. I am just using this new version of the args, the put object args. I'm using the same variable. I just created a new object. Now I'm going to confirm the upload. By the way, I really don't need this because it's doing the exact same thing I did before. So let's go ahead and pull that out of there. I'm just going to stat the object with the same bucket name, same object name that I used before. And then I'm going to output my information. Let's go ahead and run this and see what happens. So .NET build, and then I'm going to do a .NET run. And so what you see is my file example, image png is uploaded. It has an e tag, which starts 66AB, la 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 la, A158. It has a version, C9D, la 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 la, 758. Its content type is image png, and its file size, or object size, is 650862 bytes. Okay, 650,862 bytes. When I do the stream example, I'm handing it the same basic file, so my e tag actually ends up being the same. But the version is different because I have uploaded a new version of that same object name, image png. I can show you that it's a different item because for the second one, for the stream, I actually set the content type to be application octet stream. But notice that the length is actually the same. The size is still 650,862 bytes. What, though, am I to do if I don't actually know what the object size is for my stream? Well, I could do something silly like say, well, maybe it'll just guess and I don't have to give it an object size. Let me show you what happens when I run this. So if I don't give it an object size and I try to run it, I'm going to get an error. I have to set the object size. But again, if I'm doing some random stream length and I don't know how big it is, what do I do? Well, it turns out that there is a magic value you can put in here. It expects a long. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to give it a -1. And that basically says, I don't know how long it is, just take whatever I give you. So now I'm going to save that. Let's go ahead and .NET build and run that again. So now what happens? It works. And notice the sizes of the object are exactly the same, 650,862 bytes in both cases. But the E tags are slightly different. Notice my -1 is now on the end of that E tag. The version numbers, of course, are different because I'm versioning and versioning and versioning all of this all the time. But notice that now my E tags are different because I didn't tell it how big the actual file stream was, and so it couldn't compute the exact same E tag that it did before. In general, the file stream upload has a wrapper around it when you do the file version of the upload. But the big difference, and again, the difference between these two calls is really just what went into the put object args. In one case, I gave it a file name, and in the other case, I gave it stream data. And that is the difference between uploading a file versus uploading a stream when you're working here with .NET. That's everything I have for you for our example today. I hope you enjoyed it. If you'd like to connect with us, please connect with us using any of the methods you see here on the screen. You can always interact with us on minio.slack.com or just leave us a comment here on this video. We'll see you in the next one.